Hey, what's up guys? AntsCanada here. Welcome to the AntsCanada Ant channel. Today I wanted to walk you through a time-lapse video of my daily routine with one of my colonies. So first, I make sure to spot clean my outworld. So to begin with gloves, I start to baby powder my tweezers and my gloves so that the ants slip off and it makes it easier for me to work around these ants. Now before spot cleaning this outworld, I made sure to not feed them in this outworld for a few days so that less and less workers would forage in this outworld, which would make cleaning this outworld a lot easier. Now this outworld here, I try to spot clean at least once a week. So the last time I spot cleaned this outworld was last week. I try my best not to get any workers, and if there are workers on the pieces, I just wait till they fall off. It is super important to spot clean your outworlds, guys, because these ants really depend on you to remove their leftover food and midden. In nature, the elements and other creatures help break down this naturally, but because this is an artificial outworld and we don't have those cleaning agents, we have to be those cleaning agents. So it's important to remove these decaying pieces of insects and that sort of thing. It also leaves a foul smell if you leave all of that decaying matter there, and it attracts mites and maggots from gnats. So you definitely don't want the ants' garbage to be sitting there and decay. Now the next thing I'm doing here is I'm cleaning the bathroom area. I just rub that area carefully with a wet tissue. See all those ant feces caked on there? It's good to keep that clean. I also use a damp tissue to wipe the acrylic, just to remove any grime or dirt that might be on the acrylic. I'm OC that way. I proceed to further spot clean any little pieces that I can pick up there, and I turn up the gravel a little bit. I turn up this gravel layer just so it keeps the surface fresh, because if you can imagine, day in and day out, these ants lay pheromones on this surface. So if you kind of keep this mixed up and nicely churned every now and then, it gives them a fresh surface. Now the next thing I do is I hydrate my hybrid nests. So I check the hydration chamber and I see that it's still relatively clean. I had changed the hydration medium last week. Now the second hybrid nest, I hadn't watered for a while, so I'm going to hydrate it now. Alright, now time to change the drinking water of my ants by switching these nearly empty water tubes. So basically what I have to do is I have to take a fresh test tube full of water, disconnect this old tube carefully, use my thumb to plug the hole, and then dump all of those ants that were in the old test tube into their outworld, along with the cotton. I use this dental hook to kind of pull the cotton out and all of that. I'm going to remove the cotton on a later date. I make sure to grab any escapees and flick them into the outworld. Every ant matters. Now, if you look at the outworld where Solenopsis Hill is, you'll see the bathroom area. I'm going to clean that maybe next week. All right, now it's time for feeding time. Here are some dubia roaches that I'm planning on feeding them today. Now, if you look towards the back, that roach there, this roach is a dead roach. So I wanted to remind you guys that you can also feed dead feeder insects. If you have dead feeders in your tanks where you're rearing your feeder insects, throw them into your outworlds. Remember that ants are one of the world's best decomposers, so they'll even eat dead insects. You don't want to waste. Your ants will relish them. Now that this outworld is clean, I'm also going to feed them some new superworms. I think I'll throw in some more here. I try to crush these superworms by the head. I do the same for the cockroaches, but they still struggle. I don't want to crush the entire insect because I kind of want the insides of the insect to stay soft so that the ants can suck it up easier. And finally, at the end of all of this, I make sure to clean all of the tools that I used. So I clean my tweezers and I clean this dental hook. And that's it, guys. That is my daily routine. It takes about 25 minutes in total, and this doesn't include any maintenance for my feeder insects. If you keep your ant colony nice and clean, well-maintained, and well-fed, your ant experience will be superb. Thanks guys for tuning into another video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment. This is AntsCanada signing out. Hey, thanks so much guys for watching my daily routine for my ant colony. Be sure to subscribe to our videos. We release a new video every week. Don't forget to check out some of our cool playlists on this channel. And for all of your ant keeping needs, visit us at AntsCanada.com. We've got a lot of great products there for keeping pet ant colonies. We have a great forum with thousands of ant keepers from all over the world. You can learn from their journals, and we invite all of you guys to contribute and journal if you have any ant colonies. And finally, don't forget to check out our Queen Ants for Sale section where we have ants for sale. You can sell ants if you like, you can be a GAN farmer in your area, or if you need a colony to stock your ant farms, be sure to write to us. Thanks so much, guys. It's Ant Love Forever.